Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the exciting world of Fallout 3. Search Wastelander. That does not look like a Wastelander. At least not anymore. Look, there's more of him here. His guts. What a lovely way to start the episode. Oh, this is the place. The place where they came and did the thing with the probies. How did I miss this? Okay, so I'm actually going back and looking at all this cool stuff. I'm trying to find, an audio log. I actually found another audio log off-screen in between episodes, and we'll listen to those in this episode. But I'm going back and looking at all the stuff that I missed before moving on through the teleporter from the last episode, because I was told in the comments that I missed an entire part of the ship that I didn't see, so I guess we'll look for that. But also, it's cool that we kind of came across this room, of all things. This is where they probe us. They've got, like, drills and claws and zappy things, and what do they even do? I mean, because obviously we are on one of these tables, right? But, like, they didn't probe us, necessarily. I don't know what they did. Well, anyway. They zapped a bunch of people, but it looks like they mostly, like, disassembled bodies. Because we had those, like, the cryo chamber guys, and then also, what was I gonna say? The cryo chamber guys, and then the, like, all the body parts that we're seeing around, like, the fucking... Oh, hello. Have we been here? Have we been to the weapons lab? I don't remember if we've been to the weapons lab yet or not. Even if we have been here, it's worth it to go back anyway and look around, like, all these little corridors and see if there's any... more audio logs that I missed. I'm pretty sure that there's one audio log that I missed out on completely, but most of them I've pretty much got every single one of them except for, you know, a couple. I love how the alien workers are freaking out even though I'm not doing anything. I'm just walking around casually. I feel like after a certain period of time they would, like, figure out that I'm not a hostile. Oh, okay. Close. All right. Then I'm not hostile, you know. Although I guess I could come through and kill all of their brethren, as shown here. Look at all this stuff. Like, how did I miss all this weaponry? We definitely came through here because, like, I killed some people in here. I've got microfusion cells and energy cells, which I'm, like, pretty much out of. So it's a good thing that they're there. Plus, like, any ammo for the alien weapons is accepted because, you know, it's super rare, you know, and lots of alien epoxy, which I haven't been using as much, but maybe I'll use it at some point in the future. I'll have it, so, like, I'll always have it after this, but it's really cool because it just repairs your weapons pretty much fully. Like, it takes two or three to repair a weapon fully, and there's no limit on it, which is really nice, so cool, very cool. God, I just love looking at all these. Oh, another one. See, I told you. I told you we'd come back for stuff like this. Amazing. What's up, dude? Yeah, that's what I thought, too. God, I'm skipping on all of the alien worm food. I don't think that's going to be... Yeah, okay, so this is like a whole section of the ship, like in there, that I missed. Did I ever go in here? I remember... Oh, hello. What is that? Oh, God! Oh, it's a cow! It's a Brahmin! Poor Brahmin, no! How could you do this to me? Is that guy just sitting inside of the... What is he doing? Here, I'll free you. You're welcome. These guys aren't going to attack me, right? No, they're on my side. But they're not on the Brahmin side. Poor Brahmin. Experimental weapons drone. So, another reason why I came back is because I heard... in the comments section, that these guys have a unique weapon. But they're on my side, so... I feel kinda bad. But apparently they have a unique weapon. Ah, the Drone Cannon EXB! It takes power modules, it's valued at almost 2,000 caps, doesn't weigh very much, and it does 123 damage. 123 damage. Amazing. And could probably be repaired with the regular... drone cannons, but I will keep you alive so long as you don't blast me with your experimental weapons, sir. I guess that's what EXB stands for. It's probably experimental B, Because it's drone cannon, and that's probably the A version, and then the B version is experimental, so it's EXB. I get it! I get it! Are there any more audio logs around here, around these parts? Is that the only section of the ship that I missed? Because if that's the case, then I'm not really going to devote a whole episode to backtracking like I thought I was. But I'll look around more and see if there's anything else that I missed, because I think there was a whole, like, an extra section, because that's not really an extra section. That's just, oh, it's, you know, it's a part of the weapons lab that I missed. Plus, I heard that there was another unique weapon that I missed out on, so I'm going to go look around and loot all of the crates, lootcrate.com, and see what else I missed. Plus, I still think there might be another couple audio logs. And at some point, we'll listen to them. At some point in this episode, because this is the backtracking episode, so, like, I'm just going to be, like, looking through everything. So, I find myself currently all the way back at the engine room. Cargo hold! Oh, I never went in here! I never went in here! I was actually coming back here to look for a different thing, to see if I missed it or not, because I think there's a thing back here that I missed, and I'm not entirely sure about it, but yeah, I never went into the cargo hold at all. Like, I've never been here at all. Okay, alright, well, let's look around. Uh-oh. Okay, so this guy's here. At least they're robots, so they should be helping me. You never can tell anymore, though. You never know. They could be rogue. Because I never know if the ones that are coming, that are already out, are ones that are going to attack me or not. Because I know I have the thing, but I think it's only once that I activate. Oh god, ow, how, I believe that is English in some form. In some countries, that's considered English. And we have, sexy sleepwear, just in case. I'll dress up for the aliens, get them on board real. Oh god, I was just observing the sexy sleepwear. Please don't ever do that. Where did it go? Okay, it doesn't matter. I know. You don't like sexy sleepwear. I'm sorry. Don't be abusive. Just because I won't wear sexy sleepwear for you. I'm in such an abusive relationship with these drones. This is domestic violence. Cool man is not happy. Okay, so turns out, they're definitely hostile, and not on my side, but at least they have ammo that I can steal. And I also heard an alien in here somewhere, so it's not just guarded by drones, it's also guarded by aliens. It's guarded by aliens! Ooh. Oh my god, there's actual, like, things down here. This is really neat. Oh my god, like, there's some sort of thing. There's, like, all sorts of stuff from the waist in here. There's a bathtub. And, wow. And I think this is some sort of thing from the wasteland. I don't know if it's, like, a poster or if it's, like, a billboard. I think it might be a billboard. And there's a shopping cart and a tricycle and a level up. Oh, my God. My favorite thing from the wastes. Except that I guess I'm not leveling up. Okay. Hello? Game? Maybe there's more aliens around here. Yeah, no. Oh, yeah, it totally is a billboard. That's really sweet. Aha, I see. You are what's keeping me from being able to level up. It's you! You and your dome head. I'm gonna dome your dome. Oh my god, and your legs and your arms. Not only did I dome him, I also... What would you call it if you shot an arm off? If you dome somebody, that means you knocked their... You, like, chop their head in half, basically, with a bullet. Where am I being shot from? Oh, it's another freaking turret. These guys, like, they hide really... Like, they have such a low profile and do a ton of damage, really... Oh, my God! Oh my god, that's the most amazing thing I think I've ever seen. Oh my god. The mysterious stranger just spawned in the sky like a goddamn eagle from above, destroying all that is in my path. Thank you, mysterious stranger, for falling from the ceiling. I appreciate it. That's really funny. Oh, Christ. Okay. All right. Woo, okay, get my breath. Woo, that was something else. Lots of cool stuff down here. There's a Chinese assault rifle. A minigun. And a broken toilet! Just, in case you wanted to go on the toilet sometime. I don't think aliens use toilets. We got some Nuka-Cola, fancy Nuka-Cola merchandise. Ooh, an actual working Nuka-Cola vending machine. And another one that they're, like, repairing or something, I guess? I don't know. The aliens seem to have things pretty well organized. They've got all this bathroom stuff here, including the intact garden gnome, because that's your favorite bathroom piece of equipment, and some radio television equipment. What do? Excuse you. I still haven't leveled up, and it's because of your stupid... Look at him fly! Fly like an eagle in the sky. Sorry, bro. I mean, you're keeping me from being able to level up. Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god, there's also... Wait. Reed Underwood. There's also a friggin' terminal here. What the actual crap? Alright. Who the hell is Reed Underwood? Let's see here. Contending... Wait, exact match. Alright, cool. I'll take it. Alright. Let's see here. Log entry. 4/11/2063. They think we're stupid. That we have no idea what they're up to. But we know. Barbed wire, top fences, and security cameras be damned. We'll get the truth to come out if it's the last thing we do. Conspiracy has to end. We will all be the ones who drag it from the shadows. And we will be the ones that drag it from the shadows and cast it into the spotlight for all to see. They deny everything. They deny the place exists. But here we are, faced with armed guards who patrol the dunes and robotic sentries calculating our every move. They're careful, but not careful enough. I've found a loophole, a way in, and I mean to exploit it soon. Okay, so this is one of those conspiracy theorists, except that he was right, so... Moving on. We've done it! We have it in our hands! The smoking gun, the evidence we need to prove that everything they've told the world is a lie. Now let's try and, them weasel their way out of this one and make petty excuses. The only reason they've been so successful this long is because of the lack of proof on our part. Now that's all over. As soon as the coast is clear, we're bringing this thing to the press. But for now, we need to lay low. No telling how long it'll take before they discover how we did it. Did what, pray tell? They're closing in! How do they find out? What did we miss? I thought we'd cover our tracks. But there must be something we'd forgotten. The security logs were completely erased. The inventory files were rewritten. That only leaves Dr. Morley. That bastard! He approached us saying he wanted to crack the conspiracy wide open. And all the while, he was playing us like fools. He just wanted to expose us, to bring us out into the open so that they could eliminate us. Well, it's not going to work. They'll never find him. They'll never find us, and they'll never get their hands on the item. Banks is dead. Combs is dead. I'm the only member of I don't even know what that is. I'm not certain how much longer I'll be safe here. I'm placing the item in a specially constructed safe with a remote lock trigger. It'll take damn genius hacker to get into this terminal, and the safe can withstand anything. Ha ha! Oh, they called me a damn genius. The game called me a damn genius. Tomorrow, I take the terminal and the safe, and I'm going to bury it out in the desert. Well, they'll never find it. Hopefully, one day, someone else will discover the item and realize that they hold the key to unlocking the truth. All they need to do is succeed where we have failed. Good luck to all of us. Remote unlock safe. Okay. The safe is unlocked. I don't know where the safe is, but it's somewhere in the desert. I'm sure we will find it one day. Super interesting. also super interesting is vaporizing you. okay. Ooh, lots of ammo here. Just in case we need some regular old ammo. You know, the aliens were very, very organized. Like, they've got all the bathroom stuff in one place. Except for the garden. No, that's a little out of place. They got all the Nuka-Cola stuff in one place. They got all the ammunition in one place. They've got all the, I don't know, baby carriages? Is that something that's here? There's probably baby carriages. I think I saw some earlier. Ammunitions. That's good, because I think I was actually running out of some ammo anyway, so that's probably good. Look at this, the furniture. Oh, more ammo. I guess they're not. Oh, finally leveled up. Holy cow. All right. Jeez. Shit, at this point in the game, I'm so high leveled, and I've got so many points and so many things. Like, I've got a near-perfect character. Well, not really a near-perfect character. There's a lot of, because, like, my barter and big guns is low, and I didn't really focus on making a perfect character, but I could totally do it. I mean, with the level cap lifted after the DLC, it makes it really easy to get a perfect character, but I'm just going to put points into whatever at this point. I'm so overpowered, and we're so close to the end anyway, it doesn't really matter that much. Figured out how on your own how to build all the custom weapons. No weakness. All special stats. Silent running. Silent running perk. You gain an additional 10 points to sneak, and running no longer factors into a successful sneak attempt. I think... oops, I pushed the wrong button. I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to do silent running. It says you gain an additional 10 points to sneak, which... I'm actually at 90 for my sneak right now, so I'm thinking that this will be the one, just because I've been sneaking around a little bit in this DLC. Plus, I'm already at the end, so, like, at this point, anything additional that I do is not quest stuff, so it doesn't really matter if my skills are a little wonky, especially if my sneak skill is at max, because then I can, like, sneak up on a behemoth or something and blow it up with a mini-nuke, you know, like... that's the kind of stuff that I can do after the end of all of this stuff, so, and now I'm invisible anyway, because, actually, I guess it doesn't really matter, well, no, because it makes it so that running doesn't factor into it, so I can move as fast as I want, while sneaking, and that's good because I turn invisible when I'm sneaking, so the only way they can find me, because they can't find me by looking at me at all, if I'm going slow enough, the only way they can find me is if I'm running. And even then, it's difficult for them. Oh, power armor! Power armor. If I was totally into power armor, which I'm not, I'd probably pick it up, but I don't know. There's plenty of places to get power armor in the game. I don't think that's special power armor at all. I think it's just regular power armor. So, it's not really worth it, in my opinion. I heard there was some other special power armor in here, but I haven't seen any. So, I'm not really sure. There's a lot more to this ship than I thought there was. Holy cow! Like, seriously? Open door. What is this? Oh, there's, like, vehicles and shit in here? I see a spaceship over there. But first, I need to get rid of these folks. These fine fellas. This ship is really not that well guarded. You'd think that they would be, like... Well, I don't know. I guess the guys with shields are kind of like the heavies. Like, people who are... Or the aliens who are supposed to be guarding everything. But they're not very good at their job. I bet there's some audio logs in here, aren't there? There must be. I don't actually know how many I have. Oh, hello. Turret. Okay, that failed hardcore. I ran out of AP because I didn't kill the guy in vats before. I'm not used to that anymore because I've got that thing, you know, where vats refills if I kill an enemy in vats mode. Or rather, my AP refills if I kill an enemy in vats. Stupid! I'm just gonna... I don't even care. I'm so OP, man. I don't even care. I don't even care if I die, either. It's K. Why are there so many goddamn turrets? Who designed this shit? Bethesda? Oh, hey, it is an audio log. See, I told you. I told you this was worth it. It was worth it to come all the way down to the other end of this. I don't think there were any audio logs in the cargo hold, though. Although, I guess this is still the cargo hold, but this is, like, there's, like, vehicles here. Cars and the spaceship up there, which I can just walk through whatever these things are. You never know where they're gonna hide those audio logs. Sometimes they what the hell? What was that? What? Okay. Oh my god! Okay, alright, I guess that's what you get for building nuclear power. Oh god! Nuclear powered cars and motorcycles. No wonder the damn world exploded, because everything's powered by nuclear reactors, like miniature nuclear reactors. Words are hard sometimes. Is this an audio log too? No, but it totally would be a great place to hide one. Hey man, you know what? At least the spaceship here did not... Is this Apollo? Yeah, look at that. That's really cool. That's really neat. At least this didn't explode. It's an important piece of history. An important, important piece of history. Cool. Very neat. All right, well, we came, we saw, we exploded everything. take one last look around, see if I missed anything back at the entrance here. Wait, is this the entrance or is that the exit? I came in this way, and I'm going out this way? This way? With all the toy cars for some reason. Oh, I guess this is like the car room. They're collecting all the, like, things that look similar to each other. Hello. Wow, okay, you pulled out your gun just about as slow as you possibly could. I think I've given up on life. Like, I don't even care that I'm in, like, combat anymore. I'm like, there's so many aliens, and I destroy them all and vaporize them all with their own weapons. It's no big deal anymore. I also have, you know, a robot friend to come along with me on the ride. I'll take the disintegrator so I can repair this thing a little bit. It's a little bit damaged now. Hello. I'm really surprised that I missed such a huge section of the ship. This must not be... Oh, hey! Look who it is again! Man, am I getting, like, super lucky or what? What is this? What is going on here? Why? Why are there so many horses? What were they? Are they planning on making an army of horses? I don't. What? Like robot friggin' horses? Why? I don't. Look at this shit. Giddy up, Buttercup. It's a freaking kid's toy. It's a freaking kid's toy. What are they doing with like a warehouse full of giddy up Buttercups? Maybe they manufacture them here. Oh my god, maybe they manufacture them here. Maybe that's the aliens' ploy. Oh my god, this is amazing. Why? I'm constantly, like, just thrown off by everything that the aliens do. It's, like, it's really interesting thinking about their mindset, like, because they're so, you know, very different from how humans think, obviously. Yeah, this is a whole, like, repair shop for these goddamn... I didn't even notice them before. The damn repair shop for Giddy Up Buttercup. What? Alright, well, let's go through here. I'm terrified now. Oh god! Oh god! There's more! What is this? Are they powering a thing, or are they being powered by something? What is this? Are they running experiments on kids' toys? I'm very, very confused. I'm very confused. Maybe there's an audio log that explains it. I don't know. I'll listen to the audio logs a little bit later. Oh my god! What happened here? What the fuck? What the fuck? Oh my god. Test subject! What the fuck were they testing? Oh my god! I don't even want to know what happened here. I don't even want to know what this is. I'm terrified. Oh my god. And this is the end, too. This is the end of the freaking cargo hold. Oh my god, amazing. What the hell? I'm really disturbed. Oh my god. What alien? The aliens are really disturbed. Oh my god. Okay, so this teleporter takes me far, far away from here, thank god. Back to the cargo hold. I think I'll take one last quick look around. If I miss anything, I'll let you guys know. Oh, hey. Is that an audio lock? Oh no, it just opens the door. Oh right, so you can't teleport into the end, basically. Oh, it teleports you to the beginning. Okay, tell you about that at the beginning. I think I still may take a quick look around to see if I missed anything, but I don't think that I did. Oh. Wait a minute, hang on a second. This is different. There's actual like aliens here. Did I not come here? I mean, I guess not. There's like a piles of trash around. And I will look at it as soon as I freaking take out these stupid idiots. But I could tell that I haven't been here because it's obviously I haven't decimated everyone in the area just yet. Okay. All right, let's take a quick look around then. Yeah, this is all like crap from just the waste. Oh, Underwood safe. Underwood safe. I thought I was going to have to go find it. MPLX Nova Surge prototype plasma pistol. And there's a note. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, I'm going to read this note right now. Oh, wrong place. Here we go. Nova Surge prototype plasma pistol, Dr. Aldwin, Aldwin Morley. The Nova Surge has proven to be a tough nut to crack. The output is still very high, causing massive injury to targets, but it's drawing far too much power from its energy cells. We also need to get the weight down on the weapon, as it is a bit heavy for simple replacement sidearm. The problem still seems to be the coolant coils, which are accounting for almost 50% of the weapon's weight. The good news is that the housing for the weapon has been approved, and this is likely the final design. Unfortunately, I need to increase our staff's hours to 7 days a week so that we can have the final prototype ready for testing by the end of the year. Cool. Cool. Also, can I just, like... No! Don't jump in there! No, that's not a good place to go, Jepson. That's not a good... Baby carriage! Oh, Yao Guai! Oh no. Oh no. Speaking of baby carriages.
What are you doing to me? What's that thing? Get it out of me! It hurts! No, please! Stop! No! Hey now, no reason to get yourselves worked up. Whatever you need, I'm going to tell it to you. Well, I'm pretty sure you want me to talk into this thing. So, here goes. My name is Giles Wollstonecroft. I'm the current Assistant Chief Executive Officer of the Vault-Tec Corporation. I was inspecting the construction site of Vault 76 when I was captured what I can only assume are alien beings from another world. I'm not sure what they want from me or what they will do to me, but whatever they need, I will readily provide. Perhaps if I can bridge our communication gap and establish a rapport with them, we can enter into an exclusive trade agreement. In fact, instead of talking to this damn machine, I'm going to attempt to address them directly. On behalf of the Vault-Tec Corporation, I'd like to extend a heartfelt welcome to you. Wait, you don't need that. Wait. My arms. Wait, are those my arms? What did you do? Oh God, put them back. Put them back on.
My God, why not there again?
Hello, Mr. Alien. Yeah, I know. I'll talk into the thing. I don't know why you brought me back here. We've done this a whole bunch of. Hey, giddy up, Buttercup! Wow! I always wanted one of those. Why do you have one? I don't understand. What do you want? It's a toy. A toy! Why are you so excited? You're weird.
So there you have it. There's the rest of the audio logs that I currently have. I think there's a few more left, but unfortunately I missed out on one of them because it was in the maintenance section here that I'm completely missed out on. Unfortunately, the teleporter is no longer active. You have to do it between the second and third quests. Like, you have to do it during the second quest before you end the quest. But yeah, no, that's going to be it for this episode of Fallout 3. Very excited. In the next episode, we're going to be finishing up Mothership Zeta, and I'm very excited to be done with it because we're very close to the end of this series, and we're going to have a big old finale. We've got one more quest to do outside of Mothership Zeta. It's another Point Lookout quest that I didn't do before, and I kind of want to wrap that up with that quest. Maybe a couple other smaller things in the next episode, or in one of the next episodes. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next exciting episode of Fallout 3. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and check out twitch.tv/JoshJepson for live stream shenanigans, and all of the other links that you see on your screen here will be in the description as well. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.